there is a tendency to attribute very high number of kills to German tank units, as well as very high kill ratios. This is especially true for the lists of German tank aces and the independent Tiger tank battalions. These high kill numbers are based on the claims of the German tank units, which are often accepted as accurate without criticism. The reality was that the German units' claims were greatly exaggerated. Descriptions of battles during the Second World War will often focus on tanks fighting other tanks. This does not reflect the usual conditions under which tanks were destroyed. Actual tank combat focused on breaking through enemy lines using superiority of force, while anti-tank gun and tank destroyer units destroyed enemy tanks. After the war, the British Army made a comprehensive investigation of the cause of their tank losses. Tanks and self-propelled guns accounted for less than half of total British losses. That the number for tanks and self-propelled guns is approximately the same for all three theaters makes it reasonable to conclude that the numbers can be applied to the Western Front in general as well as the Eastern Front. The German High Command was well aware that units overestimated kills and that the claims did not take into account that some of the destroyed tanks could be repaired. But claims were taken seriously because of propaganda reasons. From the beginning of the German invasion of the Soviet Union until the end of 1942, the total of German claimed tank losses were 39,100, compared to actual Soviet tank losses was 35,500, equivalent to an overestimation of about 10%. Now, let's discuss the most well-known tank battle, the Battle of Kursk. The traditional Western narrative of the Battle of Kursk is that the superior German tanks destroyed scores of Soviet tanks at ranges of 2 or 3 kilometers before being overwhelmed and rammed to death by the Soviet masses. This version of the battle was written before Western authors had access to Soviet archives and relied solely on German records. It is no surprise that such claimed kill ratios would give the impression that the Battle of Kursk was a disaster for the Soviet tank forces and that Germany came close to winning the battle. While the latter numbers include units outside the Kursk area, relatively little tank combat would have taken place on the other front sections. Even after the 50% reduction by the German High Command, however, the claims exceed the recorded Soviet losses. The actual ratio between the 6,064 Soviet losses and the estimated 1,712 German losses could therefore not have been greater than 3.5 to 1 and was likely significantly lower. This should be compared to the traditional claims of 14 to 1 if using the troop claims and 7 to 1 when using German High Command reduced claims. In other words, the overall German unit claims were at least 4 times as high as the actual losses. On the Western Front, Operation Goodwood in 1944 is often described as a tactical disaster for the British, resulting in the loss of up to 500 tanks. This is reinforced by the postwar authors, who have only looked at the British overall losses without examining the way the British counted those losses. Even it is assumed that the total number of tanks not yet recovered would be written off, the total number of lost tanks of the 11th Armored Division and Guard Armored Division would be 103 tanks, compared to the 350 tanks that are often considered casualties in postwar literature for these two units. This is a considerable reduction. The definition of a lost tank is important in this regard, as German kill claims during Goodwood are often considered accurate because they match the British losses. If the actual British losses are in fact only about one-third of the frequently accepted numbers, the German claims must therefore necessarily be inflated. While Operation Goodwood might not have created the breakthrough that was planned, the total of about 150 British tanks written off compared to the 83 German tanks and assault guns written off is certainly not the disaster as which it is usually described. As has been demonstrated above, the kill claims of the German units cannot be trusted. When claims can exceed the actual losses by more than 300%, they cannot be considered credible, as even a rough estimate of how many tanks and individual units destroyed. Thus, the number of kills attributed to the German tank aces and individual units must be considered as nothing more than the propaganda as which they were originally intended. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and support my channel on PayPal. Details in the description box.